calcium phosphate transfection. First method is chemical transfection, calcium phosphate transfection. DNA calcium phosphate precipitates are formed neutralizing the DNA charge, and calcium phosphate facilitates the binding of the DNA to the cell surface, promoting entry to the cell via endocytosis. Simple guide in protocol. For adherent cells, plate cells in growth media in absence of antibiotics overnight to reach 60 to 80% confluence for transfection day. In sterile Eppendorf tube, add 10 micrograms of DNA with roughly 438 microliters of sterile DDH2O, then add 62 microliters of 2 molar calcium chloride. Dropwise, add 2 times HBS to the DNA calcium chloride mix and mix solution gently. Directly add the contents of the Eppendorf dropwise evenly throughout the culture vessel to the medium of the cells within 1 to 2 minutes of adding the 2 times HBS to the DNA calcium chloride mix. The pH medium will become more acidic. With presence of phenol red, the media should turn pink to orange. Incubate cells for 7 to 11 hours. May observe very fine particles or precipitates in the vessel after incubation. Rinse the cells and change to fresh complete growth medium. If you are collecting secreted proteins from the cells, leave the cells in the incubator for 2 to 6 days post-transfection before collection. Advantages and disadvantages. Pro: calcium phosphate transfection is the most cost-effective and simplistic of the transfection methods. It allows the protocol to use high amounts of DNA. Con: however, this method tends to have very low efficiency of less than 10%. Very low probability that the DNA calcium phosphate complex can bypass the nuclease of the cell. Hence, is usually transient expression as a result due to cellular stress. And cells may exhibit cytotoxic effects and sensitivity to the chemical due to environmental factors such as pH and temperature changes. Lipid-mediated transfection. Lipid-mediated or cationic lipid-mediated transfection is fast and simple. The cationic lipids are mixed with their DNA in a solution in which the lipids form positively charged liposomes, taking up the negatively charged DNA, forming DNA lipid complexes. The complexes are then neutrally charged, hence can enter the cells through endocytosis. Simple guide in protocol. For adherent cells, plate cells to reach 70% confluency for transfection. While for suspension cells, seed cells at 500,000 cells per mil. Prepare the DNA and transfection reagent in separate tubes. DNA and transfection ratios should be optimized for your cell type. Try 1:3 or 1:5 ratio to start. Combine the DNA and transfection reagent to create the DNA liposome complex in serum-free media. Aspirate serum-containing media from the cells and gently add the DNA liposome complex directly to the cells. Be careful not to disturb the adherent cells from the culture vessel. Incubate the cells for 5 to 8 hours before removing the transfection solution, and then add fresh complete growth media. 2 to 3 days post-transfection, transgenes should be observed and ready for downstream applications. A similar protocol is suggested for RNA transfection as well. Click on the links below for more detailed protocol. Advantages and disadvantages. Pro: advantage, the ability to be applied to a broader range of cell lines with high efficiency and able to deliver DNA, RNA, and proteins into the cell. There are many off-the-shelf, lipid-based transfection products available commercially. Con: however, lipid-based transfection reagents vary in performance and can be expensive as it requires optimization of the reagent and DNA ratios to determine the optimal conditions for different cell types and culture conditions. Suspension cells in particular have a reduced attachment to transfection complexes, thus decreasing their transfection efficiency. Physical transfection. Electroporation uses high voltage pulses to create temporary pores in the cell membrane to allow nucleic acids to pass through. It is a rapid technique which can be applied to both adherent and suspension cells with high efficiency once an optimal condition is determined. This method yields a higher frequency of stable cells as nucleic acids can enter the nuclease to integrate into the host genome. Optimization with the electroporation equipment and specific reagents are required for such experiments. Simple guiding protocol. Prepare the cells for electroporation. Adherent cells reaching late log phase in complete media are trypsinized and resuspended. Around 10 million cells are suspended in ice-cold electroporation buffer. If using suspension cells, skip the trypsination step. Transfer the cell suspension into the cuvettes on ice. Mix 10 micrograms of DNA with the cell suspension in the cuvette by flicking. Incubate for 5 minutes on ice. Place the cuvette into the electroporation apparatus at room temperature. Then zap using electrical pulses one or more times at desired voltage settings. Then, place the cuvette with the cells and DNA in ice for another 10 minutes. Dilute the now transfected cells into complete media into the culture vessel. Incubate the cells for 48 hours post-electroporation. If required, change to fresh growth media containing antibiotics for downstream stable selection. Advantages and disadvantages. Pro: electroporation provides researchers versatility or a broader range of cells to transfect, increase efficiency for hard-to-transfect cells, requires very low DNA amounts, increase stable transfection, and has the ability to use this technique in vivo. Con: using electrical pulse can damage the cells and cause non-specific transport of molecules in and out of the cell. Different electroporation platforms and reagents means optimization is required for your cell type, even more so when compared to lipid-based transfection methods. For instance, the optimal voltage, number of pulses, pulse width, buffer and reagents combinations are all factors that will affect the electroporation outcome. Therefore, satisfactory transfection efficiency using electroporation equipment can be expensive. Now you know how transfections can help you in your research studies and methods to perform transfection. We've gone through three transfection techniques: calcium phosphate, lipid-based, and electroporation. Each technique has their own unique pros and cons, and selecting the best methods for your experiment all comes down to your cell type and what your desired outcome is for the transfection. Thank you! Thank you for watching! Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for more educational videos.